Value mapping is one of the key features in SAP CPI that will help you to translate source values into the target value in your integration process. Value mapping in SAP CPI is a method used to maintain a relationship between different values that represent the same data objects across various systems. Technically, it acts as a bidirectional lookup table, allowing for consistent data transformation during integration process. Let's talk about when do we use value mapping. Value mapping is used when there is a need to ensure data consistency and integrity across different systems. It is particularly useful in scenarios where data needs to be adapted according to specific business rules or when dealing with large data sets. What are different ways to use value mappings? In SAP CPI, value mappings can be used in graphical mapping. It can be used by importing CSV files, or value mappings can be accessed by using an API in SAP CPI. Some of the examples when we need to use value mappings are, you can use value mappings when translating different business partners, or this can be used when you want to convert country code to the country name, or this can also be used when you want to convert the currency code to the currency names. So there are various scenarios where you need to use value mappings in your integration process. When I hire an integration developer for an integration project, I would ask below interview questions in a value mappings area. Can you explain what value mapping is in SAP CPI and why it is important? How does value mapping differ from fixed value mapping in SAP CPI? What are the steps to create and deploy value mapping artifacts in SAP CPI? Can you describe a scenario where value mapping is used in SAP CPI? How do you handle value mapping updates in SAP CPI? What are some common challenges you might face when using value mapping in SAP CPI? How can value mapping impact the performance of integration flow in SAP CPI? In what ways can value mapping be automated in SAP CPI? What are the best practices for maintaining value mappings in SAP CPI? And the last question is, explain how you would test value mappings in SAP CPI before moving them to production. In this demo, we're going to follow three steps. In the first step, we'll create a value mapping. In the second step, we will use that value mapping in a graphical mapping. In the third step, we will try to use that graphical mapping in our integration flow. Without further delay, let's begin the demo. Let's start with the demo. Let me go to the package. So go to the artifacts. Edit. Now I'm going to add a value mapping here. Click on add and value mapping. Give it a name. So enter the name here, value mapping, country name to country currency, also currency code. Mapping, okay, just give it a name and add and open it the editor. Now this is the editor where you actually create the value mappings here. You click on add. So you need to create the agency, the source agency and the identifier, and the target agency and the identifier. So this is a lookup configuration that you need to create for adding any value mappings. So I created agency, source A and country name, and that is a target A and it is currency code. Country name, country currency, yes, okay, yeah. So I'm trying to convert a country name to the currency. So now let me save it. So I created the configuration. Now I'm going to add the value mappings. Click on the value mappings here. Click on add. Now let me enter the country name. For example, India. I'll put country currency as INR. Let me add another value mapping here. Germany. Basically it is Euro, EUR. And similarly, I would like to add one more value mapping. So maybe France, again EUR, Euros. And let me add one more. Let me delete this. You can delete like this. Click on delete and edit. Yes, okay. Now give me, let me enter one more country, Switzerland. Sorry. Switzerland again. And it is franc, CHF. Okay, now I just added four different value mappings for countries and four currencies. Click on save. And to make it is effective in the runtime, you need to deploy it. Okay, so don't forget to deploy. So this is a source A and target A, country name and currency, and we can also add some default values, but for now I'm just using the standard value mapping feature here. Okay, so these are the value mappings now, and now save and deploy. So when you deploy it, it actually gets loaded to the tenant. Okay, it is available in the runtime for the integration process. So that is a value mapping configuration. It is created and deployed successfully. Let me copy the value mapping name because I needed it for the mapping. So let me go back to the integration process and go to the artifacts here. And then I created a new integration process here. Okay, let me create the message mapping first. Okay, let me create the message mapping. Give it a name, message mapping, because I'm going to use this value mapping in the graphical mapping. Okay, that is a demo I'm going to explain you now. In the next demo, I'm going to explain how you can access a value mapping in the API. Add an open editor. So this editor, the graphical editor we have for creating the mappings. Now I'm going to add the structures, the source structure and target structure. This same thing what we did in the previous demo. If you did the previous demo, you can reuse it, or you can create the same thing. Okay, again I'm adding the target structure. Okay, this is the source structure, the data service, and the target structure. And for information, I actually uploaded these files in the GitHub. You can download them and practice for this demo. Okay, so now I'm selecting the structure, which is the OData order structure. Okay, let me add the target structure as well, which is having my country currency information. Click on OK. I'm going to click on the ordership details. Okay, as you can see, these are red color, which are mandatory fields I need to map, which are 1-to-1 occurrence. Okay, so now let me map 1-to-1. Very simple mapping. So source to target, there is no complexity here, just map 1-to-1. So employee ID, order date, required date, shipping date, ship via, destination freight. Okay, scroll down a bit. Okay, share. So just map everything as it is, 1-to-1. Very simple. Region, postal code, shipping country, and in the unique identifier I just pass a constant. Let's test here. Okay, now this is the place where I want to use my value mapping. Okay, so now let me show you how you can map a value mapping in the graphical mapping. So click on the node. So if you go to the functions here, type value mapping, click on this value mapping, you can see the function here. Now it is already loaded, just drag and drop, and now map the input, so value mapping to the output. Now I will do the configuration, click on the advanced. Now you need to enter the parameters what I entered in the value mapping configuration. Okay, so go back to the value mapping here. It's taking a bit of time. Okay, yeah, now let me open the value mapping again. So you remember source A. So I just need to copy the agency information. Okay, here, so copy the agency information. This is source A. Let me go back. So enter the sender agency source A, and country name is identifier on the source side. Okay, now target agency is target A, and the identifier is country currency. Just copy paste the values from the value mapping configuration. Very easy, just straightforward, no brainer here. Copy and paste. Okay, so here you see on failure what you need to do. For example, if the value mapping is failed, if there is no value mapping, what you can do, you have two options: use a key, use a default value, or throw an exception. Okay, for this I use a default value. I just put an A, not applicable if the value mapping is not found, but you can also throw an exception. That's what we usually do. We throw an exception so that we know that value mapping is failed. Okay, it depends on the requirement what you have from the customer. So now I just need to get the country name from the source structure. So I just took the country name and map it to the input of the value mapping. Okay, very simple mapping. So input and output, and the value mapping does the magic. Okay, yeah. So just mapped input to the output, and these are the so agents information, okay, and default value is not applicable. So mapping is done, click on save. So after you do the value mapping, what you need to do, you need to simulate, test the mapping before you send it to production, okay. This is very important. So I have a test file, you can also use the test file in the git from the GitHub. So now I'm entering a country code as Germany, okay. Let me test it. So test, so I should get UR, okay, euros in the target structure as per the value mapping. You see, I got the destination country as euro. So I got it, so which means the value mapping work actually works as expected. So let me enter a new name again, India. So in this case, I should get INR, Indian rupees, as a target code. Okay, it works. And now let me test a failure case. Okay, for example, let me give you some random value that is not available in the. Okay, maybe we can test with. Let me test with Switzerland. So it should be CHF, Swiss franc. Okay, perfect. Now let me enter some, for example, Pakistan. Okay, so for this country, there is no value mapping existing at the moment. So it should give me what value? Any not applicable. That's what I configured in the graphical mapping. You see here, not applicable. So now close and save. So the mapping works as expected. The testing is successful. Now I'm going to deploy this value mapping, and then I'm going to download this value mapping and put it in my integration process. Okay, integration flow. Deploy. So now it is deployed. I am going to download this mapping and then use this mapping in my integration flow as a graphical message mapping. So now, so where is my mapping here? Okay, now click on download. Okay, it downloads the artifact of your SAP CPI mapping artifact. So now let me open my integration flow here. So as you can see, so this is the integration flow I already created. As you can see here, actually I have a in the references, so you know how to add the graphical mapping, right? Probably you have learned already from the previous demo, but now here you can click on this add mapping, message mapping, and from the download you can need to select the mapping artifact. So mapping, and this is the message mapping from the download. Okay, click on add. So the mapping has been added. I can use this mapping in my graph in the integration flow. So you see the third step in the integration process, the order response mapping. I'm going to select, let me rename it as value mapping, value mapping, maybe let me put value mapping for currency. Okay, now I'm going to select the mapping that I just imported. Okay, click on the mapping. So now let me save it. So the integration flow is completed. It is from the same previous demos. So I just finished the integration flow by adding a new graphical mapping. No complexity here. And let me also rename the sender. Okay, so I have the sender and have the content modifier. I have the order to call, order to receive channel, and then graphical mapping. I'm just walking through the number of steps here. So let me save it and deploy it. Okay. Okay, now the SOAP channel, let me copy paste, let me take the address because I'm going to need this in the SOAP UI call. So what I'm going to put is, and the address, I'm going to change the caller name to the old mapping here. So let me call with the same order number. Let's see what happens. I just called, I triggered the call here. Okay, now I received 200, which means successful call, go to XML. And you can see the destination currency is not applicable because the country is Brazil. Because I don't have the Brazil configured in the value mapping, that's why I'm getting not applicable. So let me show you how you can add the Brazil here. So Brazil has BLR real. So let me add this value in the value mapping. So for Brazil. So this is the currency for Brazil. So let me go back to the value mapping and I'll add this value mapping in the value mapping configuration. So let me edit here, add, so Brazil and BLR. Okay, so let me save it and don't forget to deploy it. Let me deploy it. So I just deployed it now. So let me go back to the demo again from the SOAP UI. Let me trigger again. Hopefully this time I should get BLR. So the call is successful, 200, perfect. Now let's see. So the currency is BLR. So basically in the integration process, I am able to integrate the graphical mapping. In the graphical mapping, I have used a value mapping function. So this is how you implement value mappings in a graphical way. In the next demo, I'm going to explain how you can use this value mapping by using an API in a Groovy script. And if you like the video, always consider giving a like, share the video and subscribe to my channel. And thank you for watching.